and then you go to an A1. First finger on the A string. So I teach my students with tabs. So 1, 2, 3, 4 for your fingers, and a string. It starts in the key of G. So let me play just a little bit of it. The first part's pretty easy. So the first six notes are just right down the scale. Open 1, open A, open D3. First part of the song, and I've heard lots of people playing it exactly the way it's supposed to be playing. But let's play that another couple, three times together.
Well, at least
before we go on to the next one.
So I don't have it in my head.
Don't have it in your head yet. So let's go ahead and just play that same thing over like three times.
Okay.
Section. Don't be afraid to ask. If we need to go through it again, we can do it again. This is called Living History Waltz. Weldon wrote this song. Weldon, for those people that may not know Weldon, Weldon was an icon fiddle player in this club in the State Fair and passed away about 3 years ago. So, okay, the next part changes to the key of D. It's easier to teach this part with double stops. So it's open D, open A, then to an A open with a D2. And then we hit that D2 again, and we close it off with an A3. And then we have an open E with that A3, and you're going to have a little discord, and we're going to close it off with an E1. So let's just build that progression. Okay, let's do that progression one more time. Okay, yeah, we can do it once by myself. Okay, from that progression, we go down to an A2 with the open E. Change keys. So we're going to have a 3 on our A, a 2 on our D, half step back with both, half step back with both, so you're going to have a 1 and a 2 minus. That's how we change from the key of D back to the key of G. I know that's confusing. Okay, let's try this B part again. Starts on the open, open. Let's try this D part about 3 times, but we'll have to stop for the key change, because otherwise it's going to sound weird, I think. Continue on with that first part again, because it repeats the first part. The pattern is part 1, part 2, then part 1. So, there's really, that's the basics of this song. On the B part of the song, there's a couple different variations that you can do. One of them, instead of just the opens and keeping your bow on, you can do like a little bit more of a chop. Through that section. Basically the same thing. The other one, though, is what I call jiggle bow. I don't know what the technical term is, but it's a jiggle bow, is what I call it. And you have to count, because it's 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, slide, 2, 3. First 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. The second one has the A2 or the D2 with the A open. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. On the 3, you drop the A3, and on the next one, you drop the 1. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Now we go up to third position. So, some of the people may not know what third position is. Third position is you put your first finger where your third finger normally goes. For the little ones that may not know. So, we're already in that 1 and 3. We're going to slide it up to third position. And then we're going to pick up the A3 in third position and have an A2. Slide that back, and as we slide that back, we're going to open up our E string. Sounds cool. So, we want to try that real quick? Or do we want to just play the simple stuff?
Play the what you're doing when you're descending after you're up in the
okay,
flight up
so.
There again. Down, you're sliding two down to the proper position.
Yeah, I'm sliding that as I'm sliding back down. I'm opening up the to an E open and sliding the two back to where it belongs in third position. Yes. Do we ever use the pinky? And the answer is yes. But there's, in the first part of the song, there's a couple different ways you can do that. You can either play it with the pinky, you can either play it with the open, or you can actually slide your two up into third position. G4 is an open, is the same as the open D. Or you can catch it sliding up the two in a third position.
Is that how you deal with the crown or something? So you don't have to move the bow as much? Is that the idea?
Different sound.
Just that little slide sound.
The note stops
sound
is different than the open string.
Under rest, you're playing out of tune, so it's easier and safer for the open string. So why would you?
Because it sounds different.
Because when you're playing it with a double strings, it's like a double D. until you get that little drone in there. So, should we try one more time? We'll just play the A part, the B part, and the A part, and then we better get started. Okay, and that is Living History Waltz.